Hello everyone, welcome to Code and Learn. So now we have set up our API server to use Postgres-based store. It's time to add some migrations. So migrations are used to create the tables that our operation rely on. So if you remember, when we created the store test, we needed to run these create operations to create the table news that we can use to add the records. Similarly, for application to work with Postgres in production or in dev environment, we need to create a migration that could create these tables. And in the future, if we wanted to change these tables, we could do that with migrations as well. So let's get started. In CMD, I'm going to create another directory called migrate. We will have main.go in this package main. So I'm going to rely on Bun Migrate that provides support for Go-based migration and SQL-based migration. Since we are not using Bun as ORM, we are going to rely on SQL-based migrations. They also provide an example, which is an example repo of how to create migrations and run migration. We are going to follow a similar pattern. So let's do that. First, let me import the packages that are required for migrations. First is the Bun Migrate. So go get -u Bun Migrate. Another one is to build a migration CLI. So the migration CLI will be used to perform different tasks. For that, I'm going to use your fav-CLIs. So go get -u your fav CLI version 2. Now we have that, let's create the console and go back to our migrations. Func main. First, we are going to create a DB. So we are going to use Postgres and say postgres.newDB and provide the configuration. For now, I'm leaving this empty, but later on, when we bring everything together, we are going to add those configurations. If error not is equal to nil, I'm just going to use log.fatal and provide the error. This is something I'm following from the example. So we are doing bun add query hook like we did with our database and say new query hook, but here the options will be different. That is bun debug enabled false, but we want to get the debug from the n variables. So we can do that with from n, and that's it. Now let's create the CLI app. For that, I'm going to use CLI, which should be your fav. Let's import that. In this way, I can do CLI.app, which is a struct. The name of the app will be migrate. Then for commands, we need to provide a slice of CLI.command. For now, I'm just providing an empty slice, which we will later hook up with options. Now run the app, that is app.run. So whenever the main is called, we will run the app. Provide the os.args. If error not is equal to nil, again, log.fatal error. So that's our basic setup. Now let's write some migration commands. For that, I'm just going to write a function. So func new migration command, or can just say cmd. Perform the migration, we will accept a migrator. I'll just call it m, which is migrate, that is bun migrate and migrator. This returns a CLI command, so CLI dot command. Now we can just return a CLI dot command from it. Just need to correct that. Name of the command, which is migrate. Let me scroll this up. Usage, let's just add database migrations. Then we will add a bunch of subcommands. The example bun provides has a bunch of CLI commands, but I'm only going to use the one I need here. So I can say CLI dot command. The first one is name init, that is to initialize the migration table. Usage, we will say create migrations table. That is the table that is used to track the migrations. Action, this is the callback function that will be executed. So we will just return m dot or migrator dot init and provide the context. Ctx dot context. That is the context from CLI. Next, let us add the up migration. There are two types of migration basically. One is up, which is used to create tables. And then there is down, which is to undo the operation performed by up. So if you are creating a table in an up migration, in the corresponding down migration, you will delete the table. So whenever you create a migration, there are two migrations, up and down. For up, we will say usage run up migration. I don't care much about the usage here because this is an internal tool and we are not going to distribute it. If we were distributing the CLI, we would pay more attention to this. But for our use case, this is enough. So I can do func. First thing we need to do to perform the migration is get the lock on migrator. Provide the context from CLI context. If error not is equal to nil, return the error. And then defer unlock it. m.unlock c.context or ctx.context. Now we need to create a group from migrator to run the migrations. So we can say m.migrate provide cdx.context. If error is not nil, return error. One thing we need to check is if there are no new migrations, then we don't do anything. So we can do that if group is zero, that means there are no new migrations to run. For that, we will just print a statement and return nil. So I'm just going to use FMT again. This is not a CLI for distribution, but for internal use only. And if everything works out, we just print migrated to providing the group and then return nil. So our up migration worked fine. Similar to up, we can create down. For down, I'm just going to update this to say down. And here, instead of migrate, we need to roll back. I will update the message to say there are no groups to roll back. And here we will say rolled back to, and that's it. So very similar to what we did in up. Next, we will add the create command. That is to create new migration. Since we are going to create SQL migrations, we need this to automatically create the empty migration, which we can fill in. For the usage, I will say create up and down SQL migrations. Action, again a callback, roll up. So to name the migration, we are just going to use strings.join. So we are getting the args, ctx.args as a slice and then merging them with strings.join with underscore in between. So if this was like a migration create news table or news space table, it will become news underscore table. With the name in hand, we can do files error use migrator again m.create SQL migrations. That is SQL migration, then run as a transaction again. cdx.context and then the name. If error not is equal to nil, return error. Otherwise, we will just range through the files and print a message that migration has been created. For range files, fmt printf created migration percentages f.name and f.path. And in the end, return nil. The last command I'm going to add here is to print the status of a migration. So let's do that. Name status usage print migration status action function migration status error m dot migrations with status provide the context cdx.context. If error not is equal to nil, return error. Otherwise, just print information from the migration status that we get here, and then finally we return nil. So that's it for our migration CLI. Next, what we need to do is in the commands, we'll call the new migration CMD function that returns the command. For now, I'm just using nil because we haven't created the migrator. Now to create the migrator, I'm going to use a package called migrations, or just call it migration. Inside it, I will create a file called migration.co package migration var migration. Again, this is from the uptrace example, new migration. Func new migrate dot migrations return migrations. Update the name here. Now we are going to embed the migration from this directory. So all new migrations will be created in this directory. For that, we are going to use embed, which embeds the file in the binary. And then in the end, we will have a init function, that is init migrations dot discover caller, and then provide the embedded migrations to run. This here is complaining because we don't have any matching file. Just to prevent this error for now, I will just say test.sql. Now in here we can do migration migrate.new migration provide db, then migration.new, and then an option to say migrated mark applied on success only to true. That is only mark the migration completed when we have success. Now let's quickly try the CLI from our command line to see if it's working as we expected to. Go run cmd instead of API server migrate main.go and say create. This is erroring out because we are not providing the DB configurations. So for now, let us just provide nil for DB because we are not performing any DB operations. And then comment this out. Let's try again. Create. Okay, our command is called migrate, so we should say migrate, and then the subcommand is create news table. Okay, and as you can see, we have the up and down migrations created. So up and then down. In the up migration, we will add migration to create the table, And then in the down migration, we will do the reverse. That is, remove that, drop table, and say drop extension if exists instead of if not exists, if exists, and that's it. So these are our two migrations that we need for our API server to work, that is to create the table and then the down migration to roll back. Just to revise, in this lesson, we created a small migration CLI using Bun Migrate, which will help us manage the migrations. We created the init, that is to create migration table, up, down, create and status commands that rely on migrated provided by Bun. Then we also created the migration package, which embeds the migration that we are creating so that migrator can run it. Now we don't need this, so we can delete it. That's it for this lesson. In the next lesson, we will bring it all together and run it using Tilt, which is a tool to replicate the behavior as you would run it in Kubernetes cluster. So we will create a local dev Kubernetes cluster to run and verify everything is working as expected. If you have any questions, please post a comment under the video or reach out to our Discord server. Until next time, happy coding.